This one's called Alec Thrace and the Lost Medallion. It's the story of a young Atlean living on a magical island in the Atlantic. His father, the Lord of Atlantis, is missing on his last assignment. So Alec has to spy on the new upstart Romans, and then he finds a magical gold medallion, at which point he has to go to the barbaric lands of Egypt, Babylon, and Greece to discover the king and fight the Romans.
My take on that?
Yeah.
Well, it's wickedly, wickedly expensive. It's a $200 million movie to make. Why someone's going to make that film that's not based on some prior material that already has a fan base is highly unlikely. It would have to be such an unbelievably well-executed script, which is probably that does not sound like the kind of calling card that a first-time writer would want to do. It sounds like a very, very steep hill to climb. I would advise the writer to concentrate on something that has more of a chance of catching people's attention.
It centers on a guy called James. He's a government worker and is diagnosed with terminal brain cancer. But at this point, he's hired by a government agency that tackles threats to national security. This agency has the sole responsibility of protecting the public from a dangerous organization researching the powers of mind control. And James discovers that this organization has a serum that cures cancer, but can also unlock highly dangerous mind control potential. His life and career.
I've dealt with a lot of these subjects in films, you know. This is very familiar territory. This is an execution dependent script. It needs to have a great starring part. It needs to be very well done. It's a viable idea. It's totally dependent on the execution. But again, there's a lot of things that are in there that are very common to a lot of different scripts and some scripts that I know that are floating around. So the biggest problem for this writer is going to be that there's a lot of competition in a lot of the same areas that he's dealing with. And may well find that, goes to all the trouble to work this up and only to find out that there are other projects that are similar along the way. That genre in particular, I mean, look at what happened. I mean, the success of Taken, for example, the surprise effect of Taken and the Bournes and all the rest. There's a whole bunch of films in the pipeline that are sort of in that same tone. So it's shaky territory, but it's a totally viable idea.
A pair of female amateur UFO enthusiasts spend a weekend in the middle of nowhere. They come across an unconscious naked man in the woods one evening after a suspected sighting and believe he's an alien.
What's the film rated? Oh, sorry, go ahead.
They believe that he's been sent to destroy mankind. The man, who's just a prank victim on a night out, tries to convince the girls that to save their race they must breed with him and create super beings. And then some aliens arrive.
I like that idea. It's cheap. It's castable cheap, it's funny. I think, what's the title?
It doesn't have a title.
All right, well, my advice would spend a lot of time on the title. That's an idea that could be pitched and conceivably sold to the right person. Low budget, teen alien comedy? Why not? Okay.
Yeah. Right. A young man tormented by the suicide of his father is mentored by a priest.
Wait, go ahead back to the beginning. I was just picturing the deposition I was going to be giving. Go ahead.
The young man,
yes,
tormented by the suicide of his father,
right,
becomes mentored by a priest. The priest tells him that his father's soul is going to go to hell. So the young man, takes a vow to help those wanting to leave the world by taking their lives for them and ensuring their souls go to heaven.
That supposes a very complicated theology. I'm not sure if I get the math on the behavior in that. I think you'd want to, and what's the tone of it? Is it a horror film? Does he find out that he's been misled along the way? Is it supposed to be an uplifting film? I'd be very curious about the tone of that. That's a very, and the practical, the practical nature of seeing the scenes where you're taking someone else's lives to help them go to heaven, I'm not sure. I'm not greenlighting that one. That's a little complicated for me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that's.
Right, you got one winner in there. How's that?
Yeah, I think if you don't get there first, that goes on to an alien comedy winner.
I like that one scene. I like the scene. I do like that scene. That's a great scene where they find him and they think it's great. Prank, and that's good.